A very warm welcome to Mint. I am Zara Khan, and joining me in the studio is our national writer PR Sanjay, who is here to talk about his interview with Dinesh Keskar, the senior vice president for sales for Boeing company. And Mr. Keskar seems very positive and optimistic about the Indian market and says that the Indian aviation industry will grow 4.5 times in the coming 20 years. Hi Sanjay, thanks for joining me on the show. So tell us, why is Mr. Keskar so bullish about the Indian aviation industry, considering the fact that it is reeling under losses?
Indian, the plane makers are always bullish, and the airliners are to an extent. Investors are not, going by the current trend. To answer to your question, why Keskar is bullish about the industry, like the outlook, the current market outlook for 20 years is that Boeing is telling that India will require at least 1,450 planes worth $175 billion. This is like at least 130 planes more than what they projected last year. That means 130 planes more. Is the key word here. So why he's bullish, he's telling that the reason what Keskar is citing is that the GDP growth, even if it is single digit, it's going to be humongous growth, and discretionary income of people. And the one key point what he is telling is last year 60 million took flights, 60 million total passengers. Out of the 60 million, a person must have taken 20 flights a year. So that would mean only 1% has taken, 1% of the total Indian population has taken the planes for flying.
So much optimism from his side. So can anything go wrong? Did he say something?
Certainly. Oil prices, if you see, the oil prices peaked when in August 2008, when slowdown was its peak. He was citing an example. At that time, for a kiloliter, Jet Airways would have fetched the jet fuel, ATF, aviation turbine fuel, at ₹71,000. Even now, they are fetching at the same time, at the same price. Because of the weak rupee, various other exchange rates, they are paying the same amount. That means, airlines are as good as in the same position where they were in August 2008. So that is the situation. So if the jet fuel prices are increasing further, and if there are other external shocks, these projection can go wrong, can go haywire, and the scene can change.
We've seen that the LCCs, the low-cost carriers, have dominated the market. So going ahead, what could be the implications of that?
It will be good for you, good for me, because we can fly, at low fares, because, IndiGo is now become the largest airline by passenger carrier, toppling over Jet Airways. So, which would mean you and all can fly, at a cheaper cost. But the key point of here is, IndiGo has ordered Airbus planes. GoAir has ordered 72 Airbus planes. And they are also flying, 10 to 12 odd Airbus planes. And Air India has also ordered some, lot of Airbus planes. Jet Airways is also ordering, or in the process of ordering, or already flying Airbus planes. So the market share of Airbus planes are going. Airbus is a rival of Boeing, company of USA. So we ask the question, we pose the same question to Keskar. But Keskar is denying all this, because, Keskar is telling that take the delivery, aircraft delivery of Boeing. Boeing is always ahead of it. Dinesh Keskar has made a critical statement during our interview, telling that Boeing has not faced a single cancellation from Indian market. He was indirectly referring to Kingfisher, where Kingfisher is now, on the verge of scaling down its operation. Kingfisher is largely an Airbus, fleet operator. It has 69% of its capacity has shrunk, and it has cancelled several orders. So he's telling that LCC can dominate the market, but Boeing will continue to dominate its even in the Indian market. That's a message he was giving to us today.
Thank you, Sanjay, for sharing your insights with us. Let's just hope that the Indian aviation industry lives up to Ms. Keskar's expectations. And that's all for now. Thank you for watching. To read Sanjay's full story and many other stories, please log on to livemint.com.